Scenario analysis or what-if analysis is a critical part of every finance team's job. Adaptive planning makes it simple to generate this type of analysis. So take a look at this report. We created this report to compare versions of our plans. As you can see here, we can select any two plans to compare. So we're going to use this report to perform our what-if analysis. So notice in this dropdown, we have a current forecast, and it's called forecast. I now want to know how things will look if I were to make some changes to this forecast. So the first thing I want to do is go into model management of adaptive planning. And I'm going to make a duplicate copy of our current forecast. And it's really easy to do. I simply select versions. Here's that current forecast. I say I want a new version. Let's call it what if forecast. There's a bunch of options. We don't need to worry about those now, but let's just make sure we start as a copy of our forecast version. And there is a checkbox down here I want to make sure I do so I can add this as a parameter back in my report. All right, let's go ahead and save that. Now it's going to take 15 or so seconds to change. Keep in mind what it's doing is copying millions of cells of data, creating a duplicate of our forecast version. So now that that's copied, you can see right here we have our now what if forecast. So if we go back to that report that we originally looked at, what we'll see in our dropdown is what if forecast is now available. So let's go ahead and select it, and let's go ahead and compare that to the forecast we just copied. Now, when I rerun this, what you're going to expect to see is that there are no variances because we just created a duplicate copy. And sure enough, as you look down, you don't see any variances here. So now let's go ahead and make some changes so that we can actually see some variances come into play. So I'm going to go to a simple workforce planning sheet. Up here is my version. I'm going to select what if forecasts. So I'm now leaving working budget and moving into my what if forecast version. And I'm simply going to add a whole bunch of new employees simply by copying these rows. Okay, so I've added, looks like, 4 new employees to my what if forecast. I'm going to head and save that. And now when I go back to my report and refresh it, what we're going to now see are all the variances due to those changes. And those variances filter all the way through our balance sheet and cash flow as well. So it's that really simple to do a what-if analysis in adaptive planning. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you'd like to reach out to us with any questions, feel free to do so at revelwood.com. Take care now.